Blackstone presents Hole in the Woods by Jennifer Graeser Dornbush. This book is read by Marni Penning, Byron Wagner, Elise Randall Modica, Timothy Howard Jackson, and Lauren Ezzo. Mercy and truth have met each other. Justice and peace have kissed. Psalms 84, verse 11. For Bob, in memory of his daughter, Shannon Siders, and for the countless loved ones who are still waiting for answers, for justice, and for peace. Prologue from the author. Even though we grew up in the same county in West Michigan and were born the same year, I only came to know Shannon Siders through her death. Shannon was a bit of a wild child the summer of her murder. Her father, Bob Siders, describes her as sowing her wild oats, testing the limits, like many teens. But as Bob says, just before Shannon was killed, her wild days were starting to wind down. She was coming to a crossroads in her life, and a big part of the change was her boyfriend. They had fallen in love. Serious talk of marriage was on the table. Days before Shannon was murdered, he left for a new job in Ohio to start saving for their future. Bob liked this guy and was rooting for the relationship. He was a positive influence on Shannon. A high school dropout, Shannon started discussing the possibility of getting her GED. Her dad's constant nagging to get a job were starting to sink in. A friend of Shannon's had gotten her a promising interview for a clerk position at the local grocery store. But she never got to apply because Shannon went missing the night that her friend went to tell her about the job. The summer Shannon was killed, I was also a carefree teenager, working in a floral shop in the next city over, hanging at Lake Michigan with my friends and prepping to leave home for college in Chicago. Sometimes I wonder how many times our paths crossed that summer. Were we buying a snack at the same gas station, or tubing down the Muskegon River just a few hundred feet from each other? I didn't know Shannon went missing one late July night. I only first learned about Shannon's death when her body was found by a hunter 3 months later in the Manistee National Forest near a landmark named the Hole in the Woods. My father was the county medical examiner at the time, and he told me a few details about the case. He had determined after examining her remains that Shannon had suffered a brutal death, disturbing details that I wouldn't find out until sitting in on the trial some 25 years later. This was a shocking event for our rural, tight-knit community. It cast a dark cloud on our rural county. Shannon's story is the kind of story parents and their daughters have nightmares about. Its tragedy and horrors are universal. Shannon's story is the kind of cautionary tale that gets passed down between young women from in high school hallways to college dorms. And that's probably why it stuck with me all these decades. I kept up with the case as it unfolded in little layers for 25 years, through newspaper stories, documentaries, and finally attending the 3-week trial in the spring of 2015. I desired justice for Shannon just as much as anyone in my county. We all wanted to believe that someday her killers would be found and put away. We wanted her story to be complete and her family to have catharsis. We all wanted order from this chaos. We wanted good to win over evil for her. We wanted to see right come from a very wrong situation. And we got our wish. After decades of persistence and hard work, justice for Shannon came. This triumph, however monumental, doesn't erase the pain. Her father and mother, family and friends still grieve Shannon's absence. It doesn't seem to ever get any easier, Bob Siders admits. It was Bob who kept her case alive.
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.